Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this afternoon's matchup between the Carolina Panthers and the San Francisco 49ers. We were at practice this week with both teams, and just watching them, you could tell they're going to lean on the ground game a little bit more maybe than most people expect, which is going to surprise some folks.
Yeah, I think it's going to surprise a lot of people. It's going to surprise the opposite defense, there's no doubt. Might even surprise some of the people in the stands who wanted to come here and see these star quarterbacks. Well, it's going to be about these running backs today. Let's see who can win the battle.
Come to the line of scrimmage, first down.
And they're going to run it right.
Tackle down at the 47.
When you have runs like that or big plays, and you pick up over 20 yards, that is an explosive play, and almost always explosive plays leads to points for the offense.
Has some space to work with. And he is tackled at the 44, imposing their will early on the defense with a solid effort on the ground.
Well, we talk so much, don't we, about the passing game in the NFL, but it's still about who can out-hit the other one. And right now, the offense, they are winning that battle. Nice run.
Lined up in the pistol formation, and he'll try it left. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Would they ever? They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
James going to secure the handoff. A tackle behind the line.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
And they sack the quarterback.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense in third and long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
Colin Kaepernick under center. Looking for an open receiver on the right. The tackle was made short of the first, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time. I guess that's how they're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it, and they get it. Good job.
That reception gave them the first down. Fake, looks to his left. Kaepernick gets it to Vernon Davis. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
This will be the eighth play of this drive. The ball is out. The offense was able to recover the ball.
Well, the defense always says, let's cause some fumbles. Then when you cause it and you're not able to recover it, that is one emotional letdown.
Second and 15. He'll fire it out to the left.
Oh, it almost picked off that time.
Well, that pass is incomplete, Jim, but that's just a terrible job by the quarterback. When they're running the slant route, just throw it right at their stomach.
This has been a long drive so far. Running back in motion here. Third and forever. Looking to the right side and throwing. Kaepernick able to find Mario Manningham.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets a completion. And there's some tight spots, not a lot of room, so you got to really drive the football in there.
Play after play after play here on this drive. They need to get the playoff. And James is handed the football. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Play number 12 coming up for the offense. Second and goal from the six. Looking for a receiver on the left side here.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Offense heads to the line for the 13th play of this drive. Third and goal at the six. Eyeing that left side. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
That's interesting. As you watch the receiver trying to make that catch, he knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
Offense lines up here.
Flex round, let's go.
The running back goes in motion. It's fourth down, and it's goal to go. Quinton Michael picks off that pass. Gets away from the stack, bringing the play to an end.
This defensive coordinator, he is one aggressive dude. He keeps going after this offense. And finally, he gets the interception inside their own 20-yard line and stops the offense from getting any points.
Now on first down. Middle. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line.
Cam Newton led Auburn to a national title as a quarterback. And how about the NFL? He can throw it down the field, and he can run down the field. That was a nice run that time by Big Cam.
Good piece of tackling.
That's an excellent job. Just getting enough yardage to get the first down, move those chains, and keep this offense going.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. That brings the play to an end. The 49ers defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. And now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. Cam Newton takes a look now from under center. Third and about a half a yard.
And Williams.
That'll stop the play right there. That wraps up the first quarter here in San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the second. First down here after the run. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying, we're tougher than you are, and we're just going to come right at you. Nothing fancy about that, but it's a good run. Gets a first down. Now the offense has three more chances.
Now new set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Williams got it on the toss.
What a nice run by the running back. Picks up big yards, and he did everything that time. He picked the proper hole, gets through it, and shows that speed to get the long game.
About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. Staying with the running game on first down.
This team likes to throw the football in the end zone once they get inside the red zone. This is a nice changeup. They fool them. Well, they thought they were going to fool them with the run, but it only gets a short gain.
The long drive continues. Second and goal from the eight. Trying to get it outside before the defense is set. Scores the touchdown.
Good job on that touchdown. That puts them ahead, and it's always, of course, better to be ahead than behind.
And a flag comes out. An extra point is good.
Offside defense.
Well, looks like the defender was caught in the neutral zone, Phil.
Yeah, he was. Good job by the quarterback. You know, he made that little voice inflection. That'll get him every time. Quarterbacks are a little sneaky, man.
Signaling for fair catch.
We'll send him to the 20-yard line.
Michael James is in the backfield. James taking the handoff, trying to find an opening to the right. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
And that's a big-time tackle. It keeps them 3 yards short of the first down marker.
The 49ers in the pistol. Third and three. Gore is going to take the handoff now. That's a good tackle, and that's a quick three and out.
That's a timeout by the D.
Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a 49ers team official. LaMichael James's injury doesn't appear to be anything too serious. Yes, he'll be sore tomorrow, guys, but that's not going to stop him from returning today.
Escaping the pressure, the 49ers turned the ball over on downs.
Of course, when you get blindsided, especially nowadays in this league where they do everything they can to make sure that quarterback doesn't get hit, that's devastating to take that kind of hit.
Offense lines up here. First and 10. They give it to the running back.
That's a terrible read by the running back. It's a short game, but it's all his fault. He picked the wrong hole. He should have cut it back. He didn't. And that's why he was tackled.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. The Panthers get a first down.
A gain of 18.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down. Now you can do anything you want on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. He is in for the touchdown.
I'd say this run by the offense is just, it's arrogance. They just say, you can't stop us, and they lined up and just shoved it down the defense's throat. Nice run there on first and goal for the touchdown.
The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Fair catch signal made. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Setting up in the pistol on this play. Here comes the wide receiver in motion. First and 10, LaMichael James. Now makes the move to the right, to the 25.
When you run off tackle, one of the things you're looking for is for your tackle to make a good block. And then if you have a lead fullback, can he get past him and block the linebacker to free up the halfback so he can go in between them and get in the secondary and make a big play.
Ohio! Ohio!
2 minute warning looms, and this may be the last play before it hits. Slashes to the left side. Cuts down and drawing close.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you got to look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the wide receivers and everybody hustling, making a block and a long touchdown run.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. They will not find a way into the end zone, so they'll only get 6 points out of the trip. They're lining up here for the onside kick. There's a yellow marker down on the field. They have the ball back and the play's continuing.
Another touchdown. Offense.
That ball, again, not traveling 10 yards. And what are they thinking over there on the sideline?
Well, they're thinking this is why everybody hates kickers. Get the ball down there 10 yards. My gosh, kick it 15 yards. We'll still recover it. Just a terrible mistake.
First down, offense readying for the snap. To the 25.
Well, it's about deceiving the defense, isn't it? That's how you get a lot done in the NFL. And when you can run and pass, you can deceive them in a lot of ways. Nice job by the offense, running that football, picking up another first down and moving the chains.
Williams got it on the handoff. A game breaker, touchdown.
You got to have good vision to be a good running back in the NFL, and that vision means following the right guys. The running back does it, leads to a touchdown run.
Offside, defense.
Defense was trying to guess the snap count, and it cost them there. Panthers ready to get the pigskin in the air. Out past the 20 and brought down at the 24.
Ohio! 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 Ohio!
LaMichael James is in the backfield. He sends the halfback in motion. First and 10. Kaepernick gets it to Vernon Davis.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play-action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion. Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator coming with the counter run, and the defense being too aggressive. They're over-pursuing, so you do the little counter, go the opposite direction.
Takes it the distance for the touchdown.
There is nothing like getting a long running play for a touchdown. When you do, you just feel like you're stealing something. It takes good blocks, but most importantly, it takes a talented running back to get it done, and this team definitely has one.
Touchdown, got the two-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do, and you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
Moves around him, and it's the same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. They face first down. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
So many things you could do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Newton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
And he's going to be brought down.
Well, it's just a race against time, isn't it? When the defense blitzes, can you get to the quarterback before he has time to recognize the blitz and throw it to a receiver?
Olson's in the slot here for this play.
Working that left side. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
The punter awaits the snap.
He's going to challenge the punt coverage. Up in the pistol formation. LaMichael James gets the carry. They pounce on him there.
Well, that was a nice run that time off tackle. And listen, this is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get that secondary and make a nice run out of it?
The 49ers will go with the pistol on this play. Second and six. He's looking to the right here on this throw. He had it, but the hit jars the ball loose.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
The quarterback's coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Third and six. Looking across the middle, it's incomplete. The defender had it for a moment, but could not pick it off cleanly. And James is a running back normally, but this time lined up as a receiver in the slot. Wide to the left. Ball is out. Nice tackle.
Well, they don't get it on fourth down. That was a quick drive, wasn't it, Jim? That was just bad play calling, bad execution, and go to the sideline. That's where you deserve to be.
Breathe in defense here, trying to avoid the deep pass. D'Angelo Williams with a nice piece of running on that play.
Now you know why guys like Vince Wilfork are so important to the middle of defenses. You need a big run stopper to stop these runs right up the middle. You either need a big run stopper or some really big linebackers to stop those runs up inside.
First and 10. What a hit, and the ball is dropped.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
This will be the last play before halftime. Second and 10. Throwing now to his left. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
Does it take talent to do something like this? You've got to time the pass, where the football's going, where the receiver's going to catch it, and do the perfect timing. Hit that receiver, and that football comes flying out. Nice job that time. Incomplete pass.
They face third down after the incomplete pass. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction. So that's going to do it for the first half. Panthers are up in this one. We're back here now in this one where the Panthers are leading by 7. Let's quickly go to Danielle Bellini. She has an update.
I got a chance to quickly speak with Colin Kaepernick during halftime, and he was quick to thank the defense for keeping his team in the game. He said, "We have turned the ball over way too much, but our defense has played great and kept it close. We need to protect the ball in the second half."
Thanks, Danielle. And now we'll go to the field. First down coming up. And here we go, the first snap of the second half.
They've got him down there.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home, they stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Olsen's moved from the tight end position to the slot. Newton's going to take it from the gun.
Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Well, the best thing you could say on the offensive side that time is the quarterback got rid of the football. Terrible protection, nowhere to throw it, just throw it away.
Third down. Newton's got it in the gun.
He had no time to get set.
The punt team is in place and ready to perform. Wants to give it a go here. The tackle is made. James in the backfield, single back set. They run the counter play.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
And Crabtree's a receiver in the slot. Second down and eight. The throw to the left. That ball is picked off.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Cam Newton takes a look now from under center. First and 10, D'Angelo Williams. Smith lined up in the slot. Second and 10.
They deck him in the backfield.
Got to give the defense credit here, Jim Nance. Good job on the option play. They just attacked the offense. The quarterback kept the football, but there's nowhere to run, and he lost yards.
Williams is in the backfield. Now it's a third and 13. Trying to work that left side. That catch will extend the drive.
Well, the defense, they give up a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
Cam Newton takes a look now from under center. First and 10, eye formation, and a running play. And he is tackled at the 14.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
After running it, it's second down. And Williams is going to secure the handoff.
Hard to score a touchdown sometimes when you get in the red zone in the NFL. Why? Because the defense doesn't have to worry about passes down the field. The offense runs it. They are ready to get it done, and they do, and stop the offense for a short game.
Olsen's moved away from the tight end position to now a receiver in the slot.
Third and 4.
Roxon with that hit, and the ball's going to fall incomplete.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
The field goal try. Yes, sir.
Well, that time the offense had great field position. They don't take advantage of it, but at least they get 3 points. Good job by the kicker coming in and getting some points on the board.
signals fair catch.
And a touchback.
And James is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback.
Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
Jim, that pass ends up incomplete because the defender, he just jarred the football loose with that hit. Nice job. Get that shoulder into the receiver, knock that football out, and get it to the ground.
LaMichael James is in the backfield. Second and 10. Always aware of the chains. He's got the catch, and he's got the first.
When you're behind in the football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
He'll fire it out to the left, and he is brought down at the 39.
Well, they call this route a lot of things. They call it a go route, a nine route, or a fly route, and all of them mean the same thing. Run as fast as you can, get behind the defense.
Second and 7. Under fire on that throw. LaMichael James is in the backfield. Throws to the right. The 49ers get a first down. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
What a nice corner route run by the wide receiver. He fakes the defensive back out, and look at the quarterback. He knows that little move. When he stuck it, he let him out to the corner. Nice throw, nice catch.
Brings it into his body, and the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line.
That time it was an easy completion for the quarterback on the play-action pass, and it fools the defense because look how aggressive the offensive line is. They sold the play to the defense, and the quarterback took advantage.
James lined up in a single-back formation. Second down and 13, challenging the defenders to the right side. That ball was in his hands.
It's really simple. Keep your eyes on the football. When they're not on it, that's when you drop it, and that's what happened that time.
Flex round! Flex round!
The 49ers will approach this play from out of the pistol. They motion the receiver around to the other side. Now it's a third and 13. LaMichael James, left side. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Looks to his left. They pick up the first down with that reception.
Well, they're a gambling football team. They like to take chances. Even though they're down, it's in the second half. They take another chance. They go for it on fourth, and this time they got it.
Mounting a serious drive. He's looking long. Touchdown. That'll close the gap.
And what a touchdown there for the offense. The quarterback just fires that football in there. Look at the defenders around the receiver, but the receiver big enough, tough enough to go up in there and make that catch.
They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered.
Williams lined up directly behind the quarterback here. D'Angelo Williams. They bring him to the turf.
That was a running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
Second down and six. And Williams, he'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
That's a bread and butter play by all offenses in the NFL. Get a few yards and get that first down.
Cam Newton takes a look now from under center. Now first and 10. They'll stay on the ground on first down.
Well, I know it's not going to make a highlight field, but still a good solid run up in there for a couple yards.
Offense lines up here. Second and nine. Back to the running back.
And this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time, they stopped that run just for a short game.
Looking at third down. They feed it to him again. A tackle that had to be made. And that'll set up fourth down. And this will be a 50-yard field goal try. No doubt about it. Put three on the board.
When you get great field position, Jim, you got to take advantage of it. The offense didn't do it. I blame the coach. Those were terrible play calls, but a good kick by the kicker.
Quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. And he's brought to the ground.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they hold the pursuit. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side. Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run, nowhere for the running back to go, and they stopping for a short game.
Third and two. LaMichael James gets the carry.
Always important to know where you are in the football field. That time, a good job by the ball carrier. Just ekes out a first down. Nice job.
Black Brown.
Time in this one's running out, and the defense knows it needs another stop.
They tackle him for a loss.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
2 minutes to go before this one's in the books. We're drawing near a close, and the defense is trying to preserve a victory. Second down and a long way to go, and he's thrown to the ground.
There is no decision to make in a situation like this. Under 2 minutes, the clock is running. You take a quarterback sack, look how long it's taken them to get back in formation to try to run the next play.
Vernon Davis hauls it in.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
They fail to convert here on fourth down.
Well, if your offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, then you got to help them out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out, too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
Williams is in the backfield. First and two.
Ball comes out. Oh, they cough up the football, and the defense takes possession.
You got to protect the football on the offensive side. When you don't protect it the way these defensive players can run, you're going to get in trouble, and that time it results in a fumble.
The 49ers have saved all three of their timeouts for here in the fourth quarter. First and 10, and James is handed the football.
They bring him down at the 41-yard line.
The off-tackle run, it's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
It's second down and three. James taking the handoff. The tackle is going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Kind of refreshing to watch, isn't it, to see a team that has faith, the toughness, and the patience to just keep running the football, grinding out these first downs, resting their defense, and tiring out the opponent's defense.
Vernon Davis hauls it in. The 49ers hoping to move in front with this extra point try. And the extra point is good. The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. Nifty move past the defender. Panthers coming to the line. Still have all three of their timeouts here in the fourth quarter. D'Angelo Williams with a nice piece of running on that play.
That's one of those plays. If it doesn't work, everybody's going to get on the offensive coordinator for running the football there late in the game when they're behind. But he caught the defense off guard. It was a good risk by them and a good game.
In shotgun formation, looking for an open receiver on the right.
They knocked him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
So they complete that one, yet it's still second down.
Fumble.
They recover their own fumble.
One thing coaches hate when their offense is on the field is fumbling the football, because a lot of times it's just bad fundamentals. But they're lucky this time they have the fumble. They're able to get on top of it.
Olsen in the slot receiver role for this upcoming snap. Cam Newton unleashes the long pass.
Has the catch.
For so many years, we had all these rinky-dink, dink, and dunk quarterbacks. Now we got guys in there throwing it deep down the field. What a nice catch. What a really good deep throw.
The kicker now with a chance to decide this game. That field goal probably locks this one up, Phil.
Yeah, it locks it up. And it was a hard-fought game, a lot of fun to watch. And that field goal, listen, that was a tough drive. And I don't know. I didn't feel easy about sending the field goal kicker out to make it. The coach made the decision, and it worked out in his favor.
And James is a running back, but he's in the slot for this play. First and 10. Trying to power his way right up the middle. He's brought down. There it is. The game has come to an end. It was a good one throughout. Hotly contested right down to the wire. I'm sure it doesn't get much better than that for a kicker. The game winner at the end.
Nah, they live. That's what they live for, Jim. Yeah, that's what you sit in bed at night and dream about. Kicking the game-winning field goal. Happened here today. What a great moment for him. Jim, sometimes the game of football just comes down to who wants it more. And when you see a running play like this, it is our play of the game because it's simple, it shows the toughness of the team, and the running back took advantage of a defense that didn't show great discipline.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long.